D-Day is looming for the troubled Myki ticketing system, with the Baillieu Government to announce its future within days. The Premier refusing to rule out scrapping the smart cards altogether.
He may have yet to travel with a Myki card, but the Premier could be ready to touch off on the costly public transport experiment.
Listen, you haven't even used it yourself.
Well, I've touched on a load of some money on it, but it didn't come up at $1.3 billion, I can tell you that.
The government has received a report on the true costs of Myki and will decide next week whether to persist with the rollout.
To do away with Myki would lead us to funding a replacement system, so we'd have to factor that in. We'd also have to deal with any legal liabilities.
With 16% of commuters now using Myki, public transport users have cautioned against junking the system completely. But teething problems still haven't been overcome.
Incorrect charging, there's issues with scanners not working or scanners working very slowly.
But one thing is for certain, the previous government's plan to have all commuters using Myki by Easter has been dashed. And Ted Baillieu says the Met card will be around for a while yet.
I've still got a few unused spots on my Metcards.
It may have been responsible for Myki's introduction, but Labor's now desperate to wash its hands of a system that caused it so much grief.
Ted Baillieu promised to fix the problems, and he gave the voting public every indication that he would be scrapping Myki. He has been playing games ever since.
With a price tag of almost $1.4 billion, it's a high-stakes game. Gareth Borum, 10 News.